66, we have a system in New Jersey where everyone purchasing a firearm has to go through a background check. This requires a fingerprint check that goes to the FBI. The people that are buying these guns legally are not the criminals that are using them in crime. The people that own these guns legally are not the people going out shooting up malls and shopping centers. We have to address the real problem of crime. Don't go after the honest person. When this law was originally passed in 66 and put the ban at 15, we had a one-year grace period to get rid of the magazines or alter them, and we could alter them temporarily. And if we did not, we would be guilty of a misdemeanor crime. Under the way this bill is in, we'll have less time to alter them. They can't be altered temporarily, they must be permanently altered, and the felony conviction would put you in jail and never be able to own another firearm the rest of your life if you're convicted. This is absolutely ridiculous when we're talking about legally owned guns owned by law-abiding citizens. We're not talking about the ones owned by criminals. If you want to pass a law, put a law on that says you're still legally using a high-capacity magazine when robbing a bank, not when you go out to the target range. We also have a problem here with crime. Crime is down 20% nationwide over the past 10 years, yet firearm sales are up 300%. Guns are not the problem. It's the illegal use of guns that are the problem. The collector, on the other hand, is going to be affected dramatically. Guns such as the Browning High Power that were made since 1935, that were made all over the world, were made with 13-round magazines. If you're a collector and you have one of these guns that went to Estonia or was used during World War II, the value of that gun is increased if you have all the original parts. If you're forced to get rid of the magazine for that gun, you can cut the value of that gun in half. These are legitimate collectors. These are not people who are using guns in crime. Also, in this bill, there's an exemption for retired law enforcement. I understand that. I think it's wise. However, what about the exemption for other people with carry permits that protect our nuclear power plants? What about the people that protect our banks or our federal buildings? They don't get an exemption, but we're going to give it to retired police officers instead. It makes no sense at all. We have a bill that should not be passed. It should be rejected. Thank you.